7,227 feet. Got the right gear, got the Jake brake on, got the cruise set at 45, I'm doing 50. It's 55 downhill, I'm not gonna touch my brakes once. Truck behind me is gonna pass me because he's not gonna wanna do 50 all the way down the hill. I look at it this way, yep, there he goes, he's gonna pass us. I look at it this way, he's gonna hit his brakes four or five times all the way down the hill or beyond them constantly. And I have the right gear and the cruise set and the Jake brake is on and I will never have to touch my brakes. I can maybe increase speed by 5, bring me up to 55, but then actually I'll put me at 60. If I bring the speed up to 50, I'll have 55. I could probably do that. I'm not going to. Yes, I need to make it to Logan before noon tomorrow, but I'd rather not. See, he already hit his brakes. He already tapped his brakes. I won't ever have to hit my brakes. The parts man at Peterbilt in Hays, Kansas one day, and he said he grew up with automatics and auto shifts and stuff, and he said, a trucker in front of me just hit his brakes again, that's twice, and he's going to get out of sight, so I won't be able to see how many more times he's going to do it. Anyway, the parts man said he never trusts a automatic or an auto shift, a Jake brake, to hold its gear. He's had too many trucks lose its Jake brake, and then you lose, then you're flying down the hill. Well, number one, I am down 2 gears, so, and the RPM is 1350 right now. It's working its way up to 1400 right now, so I can be able to tap the brakes and be able to downshift. Not have a problem of turning the RPMs up too high. Just truck drivers nowadays, they don't care. I've seen some guys just run down this hill on the brakes all the way down the hill. You don't need to do that. That's burning your brakes up. Yeah, and when they got down to the end of the, down at the bottom, they'd hit the shoulder, and then there'd be a big cloud of burnt brake smoke come up, and you can smell it, and I'm thinking, you idiot. Now you don't have any brakes for the other hills. Upshift a little bit here. Actually, increase my speed. Bring the cruise up to 50. They'll put me at 55. Driving the truck. Don't rely on the other truck driver to tell you when you need to get back over. That is your job to figure out when you can get back over safely. That's why I hate the new breed of truck drivers out here. I had one guy, he... that's the other thing. I flashed, I don't know how many people I've flashed, not bright flash, but just flash, the courtesy flash. Anyway, courtesy flash, which I can't understand why some trucking companies have, truck manufacturers have done away with that. Number one, if the truck runs, you can't turn your headlights off at night, which is completely, totally stupid. I think anyone that drives a truck that you can't turn your headlights off while it's running should have to pull into goddamn parking spot so they don't blind everybody else. So, anyway, I flashed him, I don't know, 6-7 different times. He was 3 truck lengths in front of me, and he didn't get over until he was like 7 truck lengths in front of me. I thought, wow, buddy, that's okay, whatever, you know. So, the only other people that I would probably flash, courtesy flash, will be Peterbilt drivers and Kenworth drivers. Maybe a few Western Stars, but that'll be about it. You drive an international Freightliner. I ain't gonna flash, so I ain't gonna courtesy flash you guys. Can you ask me why? Because, like I said, oversized, of course, I'm usually passing all the oversized. There is never usually an oversized passing day. Bull haulers. Reno to what is the town over there? It's not Donner. Truckee? Yeah, Reno to Truckee. Well, actually, just it's like from the state line, just past the state line. Well, what's the other town? What's the other town over there? Verde. Verde to Truckee. So we ought to model that. Along with the old water flume or whatever it's called. And I'll show you what I'm talking about if I can see it. See how they got water down from the... Yeah, there's a trail there. That's pretty neat. It'd be like almost like a bicycle path. You could probably ride a bicycle on that. There it switches back and forth, and there's bricks. You use bricks to retain the for a retaining wall. That was pretty neat. Water, or at least it did. And it went underneath the interstate and comes out over on this side as well. Some places it's not, it's all tore apart and stuff, falling apart and fell apart. And I was wondering if that was actually the narrow gauge line, because it looks like you can drive something on top. See right there, it's disbanded. It fell apart. One of these days, when I have the time, I'm gonna park in one of these places. I need to get me a scanner so I know when the trains are coming. Just set up shop. Put it on the tripod. Real camera or video recorder and zoom in and just record some train action. That's the thing. I have my phone hookup, which is on the other clip. I have tripods in back, two of them. One's just for counter shots. spots and auto racks on the train tracks. Auto racks. Warren Trust or the plate girder. Yeah, right? Warren Trust.